My name is Stephen Worker, a 4-H Youth Development Advisor. Today's event is the Youth Agricultural and Animal Science Field Day. It's co-hosted by UC Cooperative Extension and the Sonoma-Marin Fairgrounds. Our keynote speaker is Dr. Temple Grandin from Colorado State University, and we have 8 educational workshops by UC advisors and specialists. We have over 350 people attending, both youth and adults, who mentor and teach those students. And the event is really for those in our community who care about agriculture.
I am Dr. Allison Caney. I am the CEO of the Sonoma-Marin Fairgrounds here in Petaluma. I am especially excited to have this event here because I have a huge passion on career development for young people in agriculture. So many young people come through 4-H or FFA and are exposed to agriculture, develop a passion for it, develop skills, but then feel like they can only become a vet or a farmer. And there's so much more open to them. So this day is one of those opportunities for them to come, listen to some fabulous speakers across many agricultural professions, and find out what their spark is.
Oftentimes I hear people say, my steer was fine at home, and he went berserk at the show. Well, my horse went berserk at the show. The problem that you have at the show is there's new things there you don't have at home, like loudspeakers, flags, bikes, and balloons. Get your animals used to that stuff before you go to a show. And one of the best ways to get them used to it is to decorate the corral fence with flags and let your horse walk up to it. Don't go shoving it in his face. Let him walk up to it, explore it. You could do also, your animal needs to get used to strange people touching it. That's another thing. It's got to get used to that before you go to the show. And work on taming it down. Don't try to train it the day before the show. You don't yell at cattle. Yelling has intent. Don't yell at goats. Don't yell at sheep. Yelling has intent, and they know you're mad at them. Yeah, calm down. The first thing that people have to do is calm down. And calm down, there's a lot of things you can learn about low-stress cattle handling, low-stress animal handling. But you're not going to learn it if you're all mad and screaming at them. You got a lot of young people going into animal science, going into veterinary science. It's the young people that are going to change stuff. And I spend a lot of my time today talking to students. That's why I come to meetings like this. Because there's young people here, they're going to grow up to be tomorrow's managers, and they're going to do things better. Do things a whole lot better. And you know what? I think I'll end on that. Thank you all for coming.